In the ultimate betrayal, one's own immune system can turn against the protective sheath that envelops neurons in the brain, leaving the body paralyzed. Researchers have developed an experimental treatment that tames the wayward immune system in rodents, returning the power of movement to paralyzed mice. The approach may someday combat autoimmune diseases such as multiple sclerosis and type 1 diabetes in humans. Current immunotherapy treatments act broadly and are not specific, compromising the entire immune system, putting the patient's health at risk. Christopher Jewell and his team at the University of Maryland set their sights on the lymph nodes as a possible target for creating a specific immune response. In autoimmune diseases, immune cells wrongly flag the body's own components as antigens, foreign substances that induce an immune response in the body. These misrecognized antigens are brought to the lymph nodes, where another type of immune cell, the T cells, are programmed to attack the antigen. For example, in multiple sclerosis, the T cells are taught to recognize and attack the myelin sheath, a fatty substance on nerve cells essential to the function of the nervous system. Jewell thought it might be possible to prevent the T cells from learning bad habits by delivering an immune system modifying agent directly to the lymph nodes. The researchers first constructed a polymer particle to serve as a carrier for their therapeutic agent. They infused it with an immune suppressing agent and the myelin antigen. Effectively, this teaches the T cells that myelin is no enemy. When these particles were injected into the lymph nodes of paralyzed mouse models of multiple sclerosis, the mice started walking again within days and remained mobile for the remainder of their lives. The mice were also able to mount specific immune responses against foreign molecules, suggesting that the treatment didn't compromise normal responses. As a next step, the researchers have been testing the idea in other mouse models of autoimmune disease, including transplant models and models of type 1 diabetes. Later this year, the group will team up with clinicians at the University of Maryland Medical School to begin tests in non-human primates, another step closer to investigating this idea as a future human therapy. They are presenting the work at the 253rd National Meeting and Exposition of the American Chemical Society. Headline Science is produced by the American Chemical Society. For more chemistry headlines, make sure to subscribe.